Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Today we meet again in this lesson, in this today. How are you? How are you today, guys?
I'm fine, miss.
I'm fine, miss.
Okay, I hope that we will doing very well to face this pandemic. Before we start our lesson, let's pray together. And I will ask Nur to lead our prayer before begin our lesson today. Nur, please do it.
Yes, miss. Okay, before we start our lesson today, let's pray together. Miss?
Okay, thank you, Nur. After we pray together, I will check your attendance in this class today. So Nur is here. How about Emil?
Emil is here, miss.
Okay, thank you, Emil. Indri?
Indri is here, miss.
Okay, thank you also. All of the student is here with us in this class today.
Well, today we are going to study about geometry transformation, especially about what is reflection, reflection on several axes, representation of reflections in geometry transformation, also relating and solve the contextual problem about reflection. Okay, so guys, today you guys all will separate some group to discuss and collaborate each other to explain what reflection is and analyze the several problems relating with reflection. Before we started, have you remember about the position of the point in the Cartesian plane?
Yes, miss.
Okay, yes, please, Nur.
Remember, I think.
Please, Nur, tell us what do you remember about the position of the point in the Cartesian plane.
Okay, as well as I know, there are four positions. The first is regarding to the x-axis. The second is regarding to the y-axis. And then towards origin point, 0.0. And the last is in the certain point, A point B. That's all, miss.
Okay, thank you, Nur. It's correct, yeah? Give applause for Nur. Thank you. So basically, the position of the point in the Cartesian plane was divided by four cases. The first one is the position regards to the x-axis, and the second one is the position regards to the y-axis, and the third one is the position of the point regards the origin point, and the last one is the position of the point regards to the point A, B. Okay, now I'll give you a video about transformation geometry in daily life. Please pay attention, okay? Can you see my screen?
Yes, miss.
Okay. Okay, the video is very interesting, right?
Yeah, miss.
Okay, so those are some examples of the applications of material regarding geometric transformation in everyday life. And it turns out that today's material is very close to our life. As another example, in the world of work that often requires the concept of reflection, maybe a painting artist, an architect, and maybe some people who work in the field of information and technology, for example, people who are making online games, and so on. Okay, student, after this, you have to go to the Google Classroom to see a video explaining the geometry of transformations, especially the reflection material that I have uploaded, and a video how to represent the reflection using GeoGebra. And also, you can discuss with your groups that have been shared in Google Classroom also. Yeah, understand, student?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, understand.
Okay, now we can start the asynchronous learning using Google Classroom. You can leave this room meeting now.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, Dina.
Okay, so Emil, Indri, Dina, and Nur, all you guys have already joined this meet?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Yes. Have you finished your worksheet, guys?
Yes, of course.
Yeah. Any difficulties when you solve the problems?
Not yet, miss.
Yes? And then how about the GeoGebra? Are you get some confused in operating GeoGebra?
Yes, miss. I got a little bit confused when direct the point to be reflect. But I repeat the video again and I can operate it.
Ah, it's okay, Indri. You just need more practice and I'm sure all you guys can understood well. Okay, next we will check if your work together. Anyone want to present?
Me and my team is
okay. Tina and Tina. Yeah, okay. Please share your work. Time is yours.
Yeah, thank you, Miss Emil. Please share our work.
Okay, Dina.
Okay, so Miss and guys, so here me and Emil already do our worksheet, and we get that first we do the reflection toward the x-axis, and we get, for the example here, we name the point is A, initial point is 1,1, and also we get that the a point that has been reflected is 1,-1, and also the point B, we get the initial point is 10,1, and also we get the point that has been reflected is 10,-1, and so on, and also C, point D, point E, and etc. And we get the generalization from the reflection toward the x-axis is from the initial point A, B, we got that the point that has been reflected is A minus A, minus B. And next, the second, we do the reflection toward the y-axis, and we get the first A point with the initial is 1,1. We got that the point that has been reflected is -1,1. And also B, the initial point and also 10,1, and we got the point that has been reflected is minus 10,1. And from there, we get the generalization from the reflection toward the y-axis is A, B, the initial point. We got the point that has been reflected is minus A, B. And last, we get that the reflection toward the line y equal with line x. We got that the point A with the initial 1,1, we got point that has been reflected is also 1,1, and the point B, we got the initial point 10,1, the point that has been reflected is 1,10, and the C is 10,6 as the initial point, we got the point that has been reflected is 6,10, and we got from the generalization reflection toward the line y equal to line x is A, B, the initial point. We got the point that has been reflected is B, A. That's all, Miss.
Okay, thank you, Dina. Any comment from the another group?
No, Miss.
No? All of you have the same result?
Yes.
Okay. So far, the work from Dina and Tim is correct. By analyzing the pattern of the reflection on your geojupra, we can get the general formula for the reflection. So, thank you, Dina. Give applause to Dina and Tim. Okay, so to improve your knowledge and ability for the material today, it's about reflection. I have shared the additional question in the Google Classroom. You can discuss with your friends in the comment, and I will take it for your participation point. Understand so far?
Yes, Miss.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, before we end our lesson today, we want to conclude the material that we have discussed today or another thing that you get from lesson today.
Me, Miss.
Please, Emil.
Yes, today we are learning about the transformation of reflection geometry, ma'am. And lessons today is so fun. Also, it's a bit complicated, but I like it so far. Especially when I go through to generalize the formula generally. I've come to know how the common shapes reflect on the x, the y, and the lines and spots.
Okay, thank you, Emil. Good conclusion. Yeah, today we have learned about reflection on geometric transformation and generalized the formula. And there are several types of reflection. Do you get it well, Grace?
Yes, Miss.
Yeah, alhamdulillah. And the next meeting, we will study about translation on geometric transformation. Then, now we can end our lesson today with pray together. Pray together. That's all, guys. Thank you for your attention. I hope it will be useful for you. Stay safe and keep healthy. See you next time. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, Winnie. Goodbye. Goodbye, guys.
Yeah.